Greetings, Istarians. Welcome to my second tutorial video. Today I want to show you how to download and install the game Istaria Chronicles of the Gifted, including how to create an account for it. Lately I'm getting a lot of questions like, where can I get the game? How do I download it? What do I have to do? So today I'm going to show you step by step what you have to do until the point where you can log into the game and play. Okay, first thing to do is go to www.istaria.com, of course in your browser. Then this page opens. Click on the giant download button. You cannot fail it because it's pretty big. It's gonna ask you if you want to save the file, so click on yes. Now the download for the setup X has started. All you have to do is to wait for it. I'm gonna speed it up a little bit here on my screen so you don't have to wait that long. Okay, after the download for the setup is done, you just open the folder. Don't worry about the black boxes, I just don't want you to see my name yet. Maybe later. Okay, now start the setup. After starting the setup, you'll get the quick information about the video memory. I'll just click on yes because right now it's not important to me. Welcome to the Istaria Setup Wizard. This wizard will guide you through the installation of Istaria. It is recommended that you close all other applications. Yeah, we know that already. Just click on next. Okay, now if you want to, you can read the license agreement. I'm not going to do it. On the next page, it's going to show you where it's going to install the game into. If you don't have a special place you want the game to be installed into, it's going to create an own folder. When you're done, click on install. Then, if you didn't install Java already, there will show up an information about that you have to install it. I'll check how the message will be if you get one. Java needs to be installed or updated for Istaria to work properly. Please click yes to visit the Java website. Click no if you got it covered already. I got the game covered with Java, so I'll just skip this one with no. Now it'll need a little bit time to install the game itself. I'm going to speed it up here again. So yeah, wait a little bit. Okay, after it is done, I will send you a new message. Installation complete. Do you want to clean up any install files that were downloaded during the setup? I just say yes. Okay, and while it's doing the cleanup in the background, you can go and create your account now. Installation complete. Please click yes to create a login account, no if you have it covered. Okay, I'm going to do this with you together. So let's get it started. If you click on the yes button, it will lead you to another page of istaria.com. And on this page, you will be able to create your account. You can also reach this page by going to the homepage of istaria.com and click on the Create Account button. It will basically open just the same page as before. So what we're going to do now is click on, yes, New Players, click here. Now that will lead you to a new page. Welcome to Istaria Sign Up. To play Istaria, a computer with 3D graphics card, at least 1 GB of memory and 2 GB of storage is required. It's a standalone game only played in a browser. Okay, this is the sign up now. At the beginning you get the free access. It just means a level cap of 15 per school, no plot or lair, 1 character slot, 10 global consignment slots, that means you can't sell more than 10 things at a time, and 1 current login. You can't log in with 2 characters at the same time. And you can't use account upgrades. Just let's skip to the creation of the account. I'm gonna take a test account. Please, developers, forgive me for making a fake account. For an email, I created a throwaway email, so try to spare me. It's not my own email. I'm going to delete it afterwards. Put your email inside here. Then choose a login ID. It's going to be used in your launcher. When you launch the game, you need to enter your ID and the password. It's not going to be the name of your character, don't worry. Then you choose a password. I'm not going to tell it. You confirm your password. And then you need to enter a text here. Whatever it is, its purpose is to see if you're a robot or not, I guess. And then you take a secret question. Let's take, what is your favorite Istaria race? You should already know it. For me, it's of course the dragon. And click on continue. A verification email has just been sent with a link to activate your account. If you do not receive this email within the next 5 minutes, please check your spam folder. Okay, you should have gotten an email now. Check your email. Okay. There it is. Sorry about the black box down there again. I don't want you to see this link. For safety purposes, I guess. Anyway, you get the link to activate your account. Please click on the link below. You can't see it right now because of the black box. Don't worry. You will get your own one. Sign up complete. Click play Istaria on your desktop to log in or download now. Okay, we already downloaded it. Anyway, now I'm going to show you how to log into your account on istaria.com. For example, if you want to upgrade your account from the free access, you go up there to the homepage, login account, you enter your username and your password. Give me a second. And log in. Okay, this is the page for your account. You see your support access. It's a point where you can access support and ask for help, write tickets. Your actual subscription or service is the free access. You can log out or change password and edit your profile. Now, if you go to add/renew service, you can change your service type. If you want to stay with the free access, you will have to repeat it monthly. Just go to your payment system, then select free or trial access, and then order. The developers are doing this to know how many people are still using their accounts and how many accounts are inactive. So they see how much people still play Istaria. If you want to upgrade your game to have the full experience of having more than one character, or maybe even when they have a plot in the game and level up to 100, you go to your service type here, and then you can select that what you want. The basic access is a normal gameplay. You can play the game fully through. You have to do this payment monthly, of course. The basic subscription is 1 month recurring. And the property holder access for 1 month will give you a plot or a lair, whatever you want, for 1 month. Okay, you have to pay this monthly again. I'm sorry, but this is the way it is. Subscription, and then you can select for 6 months, 12 months. And down here you have character name change tokens. For around $5 you can change the name of your character. A character recovery token. If you ever delete your character and say to yourself, oh no, I didn't want to delete this one, I want it back, the developers will do what they can. It's no guarantee for success, but you have a good chance to get it back. Then a character transfer token. If you want to transfer a character of yourself to another shard, another server, better to say. For example, from Chaos to Order. And then you have the character appearance change token. If you want to change the complete appearance of your character. Well, in my opinion, if you change your character, it's going to be a completely different person if you like role playing. But yeah, nobody asks me, of course. If you selected whatever you want, then you can choose the payment system, PayPal for example, and click on order. And then you need to pay via PayPal or whatever you took. On cancel history, you see your actual subscriptions, the service you're using right now, the free access, it's for me, and the support access, it's lifetime free, of course. Support will always react to your tickets. They might take a little bit of time. Okay, that's basically everything I wanted to show you. Let's log out right now. Okay, that's it. By this time, the Istaria setup should be done with cleaning up. So, now you should have the Play Istaria button on your desktop. Double-click it and the launcher should show up. Give it a little bit of time. There it is. All you have to do now is enter your username you created, it's the ID, and your password, if you still remember it. Then click on login. You can save your password or not save the login. Anyway, welcome to Istaria. To get started, click through the EULA. You can read it if you want it. I'm just going to skip it right now. Please review, accept. I'm going to skip all this stuff now. If you want to read it, you can. Anyway. Now, when your launcher is done, this page should open up. On the left side, you should see your characters. I don't have any at the moment. To create one, just simply click on the new button and then you get to the character creation. I'm gonna show you that a different time in another video. What I wanna show you now is if you don't have the Play Istaria button on your desktop for any reason. You just open your programs in your computer, program files, and search for your Istaria folder where you installed it. Double click it. And search for the J launcher. There it is. Double click that, and with that you can start the launcher manually. You could also create a desktop connection for it. Cool, I already saved my username and password. Okay, that's basically everything I can show you today. I will create another Let's Play where I'm going to show you how to create a character, but that's a different story. For today, I'm going to say thanks for watching. Till next time.